Hi everyone, welcome back to Belinda's Knitting Cafe. Since the last video, it seems like there's a lot of new people here, hopefully. So I thought that in this episode, I would do a discussion about how I became a knitter and why I knit. So I'm thinking of hopefully being able to put out 2 videos per month, like every 2 weeks. And one video will follow the format of FOs, works in progress, and acquisitions. And then the other video will be like a topic discussion, like a knit and chat. Except for today, the project I want to knit on, I got some new acquisitions. I went to a Shepherd Festival here in Minnesota and I picked up some new yarns and just was so excited that I started knitting a project. So for today's drink on Belinda's Knitting Cafe, mix it up for you. It is a strawberry yuzu odd. Strawberry yuzu odd. So I went to San Francisco for Yoongi's concert and I stopped by this one shop and they had some yuzu syrup, so I picked some up and I made my own strawberry syrup, and it's just a great summery spring, I guess it's not summer yet, but it's a warm weather refreshing drink. I'm gonna take a sip. Nice. So my acquisitions from the Fiber Festival. The first yarn I have to show you is this from Pearly Shell Fiber Arts. It looks like this. This is hand spun. The pink one is Merino Alpaca Sparkles and 195 yards worsted weight. And then this is just a white hand spun Alpaca Merino, 380 yards. So when I was at the Fiber Festival, I was really looking for some more woolier yarns, and also looking at the hand spun, I don't have any ability to spin my own yarn, and I feel like I don't really have the space and the time right now to do it, and I just kind of want to enjoy knitting at the moment. So I was looking for some like beautiful hand spun and I came across this like from the shelf. And you know, I'm a lover of color. I love pink, I love orange, I love green. There's like little bits of green in here, and I love sparkles. So you know what, it just called to me, and there was only one skein, so I ended up picking this one to go with it. I'm hoping to make either a shawl or maybe a vest, because I think this comes out to less than 600 yards. I'm thinking I can knit it up at a worsted, I guess a worsted weight project, or maybe an Aran weight project, because the hand spun, there's some like thick and thin areas. And maybe if I wanted to do a bigger shawl, if I picked like a lacy pattern, I got some of the Japanese knitting stitch books from the library. So I've been looking through that to see if there's anything that I would be interested in using to design a shawl. So that is what I'm thinking, and I really love these beautiful yarns. I don't know when I'm gonna knit with them, but they do feel very like spring and summery, so we'll see. And the next one is, I got a bunch of yarn from the Purveyor of Fine Yarns, and they are they're based in Wisconsin. I was talking to the person at their vendor stall, and she was talking about how she works with a lot of small farmers in her area, because the individual small farmers may not have enough like fleece to produce yarn themselves and to get it milled and spun. So she collects it all from like these small farmers and then puts it together and then sends it off to get milled and turned into yarn. So I am working on, I'll show you my work in progress and what I'm hoping to work on as we knit and chat. It's the Ova sweater by the Petite Knitter. You can see how the yoke is going so far. My gauge is like extremely different from the one in the pattern. So I am knitting the smallest size with hopes of getting maybe a size 2 or 3. Or I guess 4. I'm hoping, I think doing the math, I think it ends up approximately maybe around 40 inches, which is I think really good. I like a lot of my sweaters around that size because there's a fair amount of positive ease, and I think I like that really cozy little oversized look. So this is what it's looking like so far. It's very cute. I like the little sheep how that's been popping out. So for my base yarn, I've been using from the purveyor of Fine Yarns. Actually, I think this is like a contrast color one. It is this pale marl Romadale in a DK weight. So I think it just looks really beautiful in the light. And all of these yarns, I picked the ones that weren't dyed. So they're all the natural colors of the sheep, which I think is really cool. And I think it'll look really nice when I have it all finished and knitted up. And then for my main color, it's this one. It is the Corriedale Romadale Cross yarn. So it's like a brown color. It looks really beautiful. And even though this is a more like woolly yarn, it's actually been pretty soft. And then I have for my first contrast color is this. What happened was my puppy got into it and is no longer in nice cakes. So let me see, where's the tag for it? It is, okay, I found the tag. Romadale, and it's just in this gray color. So it's got some like tweedy bits in it too, which is kind of fun to knit with. And then we have the white. This is the white, and I believe this is Corriedale. Let me check. Corriedale, yeah. So just a naked white yarn. And then I also have this darker colored. It's also Corriedale. And these two Corriedales are worsted weight, so I'm blending like DK and worsted together and hoping, you know, it comes out in this pattern that I am modifying because my cage just look very different. But I've been really enjoying the experience so far. The pattern is pretty fun to knit with. It's not super descriptive, so I guess, you know, for people that are a bit newer to knitting and doing color work, me, it's been a bit of a, I feel like because I have a lot of knitting experience, and I guess I have been doing that, like color work great gingham sweater is not that bad. But if you are newer to knitting and color work, maybe look up some YouTube videos. So it's going well so far. I am getting towards the end of the yoke, and there's this corrugated neck line, I guess, which was kind of fun to do. I never done that, something like that before. And I ended up knitting this. I did the neck in size 7. And then I think I was going to do the body in size 4, but I ended up doing the color work in size 5, all US needle sizes. And I don't know, I guess I like how it's looking right now, and we're just going to see by the time I get finished with the yoke how big it is. And I was thinking, like, with the color work, doing like sizing up a needle, and then maybe I'll size back to the 4, but just kind of whatever ends up looking more consistent. So that brings us to our topic. Let me take a sip because I've been talking a bit. There's like strawberry pieces in it from the syrup that I made. So I love fruit, and I think it's very fun to have fruit in your drinks. So going on to the topic, I have my notes here because this is actually the second time I am filming this video, because my first time I feel like it was a little disorganized, and I'd rather be a little more organized. So talking about how I started knitting and then why I knit. How I started knitting was actually when I was 9 years old. My mom taught me how to knit, and she also taught me how to crochet, but I think I just kind of latched more onto knitting. I think it was also hard because my mom is right-handed and I'm left-handed, and when it comes to crochet, like knitting, I can knit right-handed. I guess it's fine, like with my the right needle being the one that's doing the knitting, I guess. But with crochet, I don't think I could crochet with my right hand unless I really, really practice with it. So it was kind of difficult for her to teach me how to crochet. But I started when I was 9. Like when I was growing up, I did a lot of arts and craft things. I don't know, I think it's just like what I enjoyed doing, and then what my family, I guess, provided as enrichment was a lot of arts and craft things. Like, I liked drawing and, I don't know, making stuff and just being creative. That was always something that I really enjoyed. So my mom, I guess, introduced me to knitting. And I found, actually, I always like said in my mind that I started knitting when I was 9, but I actually found this journal from school when I was in, I don't know what grade, whatever grade I was when I was 9. And it talks about me. I was like, I'm very excited to go home and start knitting a new scarf or a new sweater for my Build-A-Bear husky dog. So hopefully one day I'll be able to knit something for my real dog, when he, you know, stops biting stuff, his clothes. But I even have some of the things that I knitted when I was young. So actually, this is a crochet, but it's my RJ keychain, and I stuck this beret, this crochet beret that I made on him. So I think it's just funny. I found it, I don't know, somewhere in our storage, and then I just thought it would be kind of funny if you put it on RJ. So RJ's now got a crocheted beret. Yeah, I cannot tell you much about it, but this is what it looks like. It's very cute. I will put it back on him, and I think I have another one right here. It is also on RJ, because RJ has this red scarf, and red and white, the red scarf kind of stains RJ, so I thought I would put this knit scarf under him so that he wouldn't get so stained red. But this is just a garter stitch, like, little scarf that I made when I was little, and I just put it on him. It's now getting into warm weather, but RJ is still gonna be wearing this scarf. So those are like some of the things I found when I was little. I did, I think, attempt to make a little sweater for a stuffed animal, and for the most part it worked, but it was just like a lot of fun. And since then I like knitted on and off. I think because I started off, you know, doing accessories, and honestly I'm not a big accessories person. Like, I do live in a very cold place, so I will wear my mittens and scarf, but I'm not a sock lover. I don't really like wearing socks, just, you know, in general, actually. So there's not much incentive for me to wear socks. And then also, I don't like wearing hats. I don't know, I just don't like stuff on my forehead. So I tried making a headband and it was okay, but I think I'm gonna take it apart and just use a yarn for something else, because I just don't get as much use for it. So I started off as an accessories knitter, so that kind of made me go like on and off, because like, how many scarves do you really need? How many hats do you really need when you don't wear hats or pairs of mittens? So on and off. And I think I knit my first garment. What happened is, like, in high school, I went to visit my cousin in Maine, and she is also a knitter. She makes hats and she sells them at like local markets there. So when I visited her, she's actually quite a bit older than me, but when I visited her, I got back into knitting. And then I think eventually that's when I made my first pair of socks, and I think that's when I also made my first garment, a sweater. And I think I'll put a little picture of that here. I show it off in my first like knitting lookbook video, but because back then I was knitting with hand-dyed yarn and I didn't understand the whole concept of, you know, alternating rows, alternating skeins, there is a, you know, a very distinct line where the color changes. And so now that sweater belongs to my mom, and she is enjoying wearing it because it's warm. And then I think the second time I made a garment was in college. So I just kind of knit, you know, on and off in college. And I knitted the flax sweater, and I did a little modification, so that like on the flax sweater, there's this garter column on the sleeve. So I did a cable on it. And then, you know, just knitting on and off. And then I think it was 2020, around September, that I got back into knitting. I saw these patterns by Goodnight Day for bulky sweaters. I don't know, I just really love the look of like bulky yarn because it's just so soft and plush and pretty. So that's how I got back into knitting. I actually don't wear those or knit with bulky as much just because I already have so many garments. I have like 2 sweaters, 1 cardigan, and a vest. But because I have all that, I don't really feel inclined to knit with it. And it's just like with my poppy as well, I feel like that bigger bulky yarn that isn't really tightly spun is a bit more delicate. So I haven't been able to wear much of it because I don't want him to tear up my sweaters. Because he definitely seeks them out when he gets a chance to run into my room. So I started off with that, and then I have just been knitting pretty much almost nonstop. There was a period last year where I guess you could say lost my knitting mojo, and I don't know, I just did not have much motivation to knit, but I've been getting into it again and really enjoying it. So most of the time I just, when I don't know something, I'll look it up on YouTube and then learn it that way. And I guess that's how I would say I got into knitting. I'm gonna take a sip. And then we'll move on to the next topic, which is why I knit. So let me just stare at my notes over here. I think I just love being able to make my own clothes, and I feel like that connection you make of like how much work and time you put into something, it makes you really more inclined to wear it. I think my favorite items are really my knits, and like whenever I leave my house, those are the things that I want to reach for. I don't have any like summer warm weather knits. I am a much a cozy winter knitter. As you can see, it is now May and I am making a colorwork wool sweater. But I just like really love being able to make my own clothes and wear my own clothes, and I don't know, I think that's very fun, like being able to customize your own clothes. And I'm also just like one of those people that always have to be doing something with my hands. So I really like knitting when I am not doing anything, I guess. When I'm reading, when I'm listening to audiobooks, when I'm watching YouTube or watching TV, I really like to do knitting. When I go places, I like to bring my knitting. I've been bringing it a lot just because I don't know, it's really enjoyable. And I think to some extent, like some people say knitting helps their concentration, and I think it does too. Because I think I just need something to do with my hands. And then I also, what is it, like how with like knitting, I can be more intentional with my closet and what I add to it. Like at this point, I have made so many knitted items, and I think that was probably like part of why last year I went into that knitting slump, is that I had so many knitted items, and then just thinking about, you know, what I'd really want to add to my closet, what do I really need to add to my closet. And need is not really, when you have as much knitted stuff as I do, I feel like it's not really much of a need, but it's a want. And it's enjoyable to be able to like produce something, and I don't know, I think just, you know, being very intentional about it and learning, I guess also learning new things. And I've really been leaning into knitting for self-love and self-care. And I wrote this thing, if you saw my short or if you're following me on social media, you might have seen I made this post before, and it says, something I've been thinking of lately is the idea of knitting for self-love. The idea that every stitch I knit over many hours it takes to complete a project is a testament to the love I have for myself. It is the creation of a garment that will give me warmth, that will hug me, that will make me feel beautiful. It is an expression of how I'm feeling and how I want to present myself to the world. It is a piece that I will be able to carry with me throughout my life, that will become a part of my daily life and also a witness to so many memories. So I just really love the idea of like knitting, creating something for yourself. Like, I am very much a selfish knitter. I don't really like to knit things for other people, and I think that's fine. I think that's, you know, something that you can choose to do if you want to, and if you don't want to, then you can choose to not do it. Because if you are a person who does knit or does fiber arts, you know how much time it takes to put into this, and will the other person appreciate it? Will they take care of it? Will they understand that it takes a lot of time and a lot of money to actually produce something like this? So I am very much a selfish knitter, and I really like the idea of, like, all this time that I spend knitting, I am making something beautiful for myself, and I'm making something that, you know, will give me comfort, that will keep me warm when I'm cold, and will give me, you know, like a hug. I really like, you know, soft things, and something that will make me feel beautiful, because, like, I feel very proud when I'm able to wear my knitwear, and something that will be a part of my memories, because, you know, the memory of knitting the item and that time period it took for you to knit that item, and then also just the memories you will make while you wear it. I think that's also a very beautiful thought of, like, you know, when you look back in your pictures and you'll see these items that you made yourself and be a part of your story and a part of your life. And me, I really like, I know it's a great immense privilege to be able to afford high quality yarns, and I think I'm at that place in my life where that is something that I really want to do, because when I make knitwear, I want it to last my whole life. I want to be able to pass it down to people later on. I think it'll be very hard for me to, like, you know, give up my knitting unless I really do not like it, like the ones that I give my mom. But I am very, like, try to be very intentional about that, and also very intentional about the people that I support while I am doing this craft, this art. Sometimes I, like, prefer to think of knitting as my art, because I don't know, I think there's more to it, and there's more meaning that I place in it than just a craft or just a hobby. And maybe it's, like, the way that we define craft now, but at least hobby has this more, like, not super, super, super intense connotation to it, I guess. And I really do spend a lot of time knitting and thinking about it, and yes, so I like to sometimes think of my knitting as my art, and just kind of, I guess when you, you know, give meaning to something, that's when it starts to cross over. At least that's what I feel like. So knitting for self-care, being intentional, and also just, like, I mean, there's a lot of conversation about, like, how knitting is a more sustainable way to consume and create clothing, and I think, you know, it's a very complex topic, but at least you can cut out the unsustainable practices where, when it comes to, like, producing clothes and putting clothes together and making clothes, because you are the one who's making it. So that was also my, like, when people ask me if I can make them something, I'm like, are you trying to exploit my labor? Because it takes a long time to make something. And then give it away for free, or not, like, the price you're actually due for the amount of time you put into it. So yeah, and then I guess all I have left is saying just, like, being creative and making something. I really like that, and being able to express yourself in your knitting. And I think that's something that I really kind of, like, hit me in the past year, is just, like, how the things you wear, you can really, like, express yourself and your personality and the different aspects of your personality. Because I feel like when I'm wearing something that's a bit more edgy, that's a bit more, like, showy, like this, I kind of carry myself in a different way than if I were to wear, like, an oversized, very soft looking sweater, like a mohair sari silk wool sweater that's, like, soft and pretty, or if I were to wear something that's, like, very, like, feminine and elegant. And I don't know, I think that's just, like, the way that I the different clothing makes me feel, and how different clothing kind of allows me to present different aspects of my personality. And I think that's just very fun, and to be able to create your own knitwear and kind of play with that idea, I think it's very fun. So I think in conclusion, that has been this video. Hopefully it's not too long, and hopefully you enjoyed it. I got like halfway through the row, because at this point it is very many stitches on my needle. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and welcome to my knitting podcast. Hopefully I can post somewhat regularly. Let me know how you got into knitting. Like, I think knitting has become a lot more popular these days, so it's really fun to learn about how people got into knitting, and what, you know, why do you knit? Do you knit for yourself? Do you knit for others? I think some people do really like being able to knit for others, but I'm here on the selfish knitter side. Anyways, like, why do you knit? Like, why do you enjoy it and do this art? I think that will be it for now. So hopefully we'll see you soon. Thank you for watching. Bye. I realized I forgot to tell you what I'm wearing. So this is a top that I designed myself. It's got different cables on it. I was inspired by a top that Rosé from Blackpink wore. So I ended up making this myself with, I think, Barocco Pima cotton. And I think it turned out well. It turned out, you know, better than I could expect. I had some like German short rows here to get it to like go, what's it, sideways, sideways, diagonally. And then I have some shaping here so that the waist is smaller, and then it can increase as it goes up. So that is what I am wearing. I don't know, I probably would not make a pattern out of this, because I did not take very good notes when I make patterns, but I really like how it turned out. So that's what I'm wearing. And now